লং ভয়েজার্স, সবাইকে জানাই শুভ মহালয়া, হ্যাপি মহালয়া টু এভরিবডি। সো টুডে ইজ এ স্পেশাল ডে ফর বেঙ্গলিজ বিকজ টুডে ইজ মহালয়া, টুডে ইজ অলসো বিশ্বকর্মা পুজো। সো মহালয়া বিগিনস দ্য ফেস্টিভিটিজ অ্যাকচুয়ালি ফর দুর্গা পূজা। সো দিস ডে মার্কস দ্য অ্যাডভেন্ট অফ গডেস দুর্গা অন দ্য আর্থ অ্যান্ড দ্য সেলিব্রেশন স্টার্ট ফ্রম টুডে অ্যাকচুয়ালি। This year is a little different, 2020. Life is different over the last 6 months because whatever is happening around us. But today is still a very, very special day. So what happens for Bengalis who are outside Bengal? It's a little difficult for us on special days like this because we are away from our home. So in Kolkata, we are, you know, checking out Facebook of our friends and families, and we know that although the celebration is muted, there is something happening in Kolkata. People are flying kites because today is Vishwakarma Puja. There are pujas in factories, offices, because today mostly all the factories, they have this puja for Vishwakarma Puja. Again on Mahalaya, people are making trips to different you know, places for shopping, picking up stuff. Some people have visited Kumotuli today. So it is a holiday also in some offices, definitely in Kolkata. We used to have a holiday when we were in school and college. So today is a special day, no doubt, for people who are staying in Kolkata. But for people, bongs outside Bengal, I think it's a little difficult. Karon, kichu bojha jay na, actually. Everything is normal around, right? People are just doing their normal course. But we are from Kolkata, the core of our heart. We are bongs, and Mahalaya makes us nostalgic, so we can't really miss this day. We can't miss celebrating this day. So Mahalaya is probably incomplete without wearing a sari. I think the only way I can celebrate today is by, you know, going down the memory lane. We did watch Mahishasur Mardini in the morning, and that brought back a lot of memories from childhood. ছোটবেলায় মা যেরকম সকাল চারটের সময় ডেকে দিত, তাড়াতাড়ি ঘুম পাড়িয়ে দিত রাত্রিবেলা। সকাল চারটের সময় ডেকে আমরা সবাই মিলে কফি আর বিস্কিট খেতে খেতে মহিষাসুর মর্দিনী শুনতাম রেডিওতে, তারপর টিভিতেও দেখতাম ডিফারেন্ট প্রোগ্রামস। তো আজকে সকাল থেকে খুব নস্টালজিক ফিল হচ্ছে। নর্মাল ডে ছিল, উই বোথ ওয়ার ওয়ার্কিং, ইট ইজ আ ইউজুয়াল ডে। অ্যাজ আই সেড, এখানে বোঝা যায় না অ্যাকচুয়ালি যে বিশ্বকর্মা পুজো, নট আ সিঙ্গল কাইট ইজ ফ্লাইং এনিওয়ে, মহালয়া বোঝা যাচ্ছে না। বাট ইট ইজ এ স্পেশাল ডে, উই কান্ট ডিনাই ইট। তো আফটার দ্য ডেজ ওয়ার্ক উই হ্যাভ কাইন্ড অফ অলমোস্ট র্যাপড আপ, উই ডিসাইডেড কি লেট ইস মেক দিস ডে আ লিটল স্পেশাল বিকজ থিংস ওভার দ্য লাস্ট সিক্স মান্থস আর নট গুড, পিপল ওয়ার স্ট্রেসড আউট অ্যান্ড পিপল ওয়ার স্যাড। সো ওয়াই নট ইউ নো জাস্ট গ্রাস্প দি স্মল অপরচুনিটিস, ওয়াই নট সেলিব্রেট দি স্পেশাল ডেজ, বিকজ ইট কামস ওনলি ওয়ান্স এ ইয়ার। তো কিছু না করলে মন খারাপ হতো, কি করবো কি করবো ঠিক করতে করতে ফাইনালি আই ডিসাইডেড আই উইল টেক আপ আ লিটল, বিকজ এই লকডাউনে ওয়ান থিং দ্যাট আই হ্যাভ বিন রিয়েলি রিয়েলি মিসিং ইজ ওয়্যারিং আ সারি। সো অগেন দিস ইজ আ ভেরি স্পেশাল সারি, দিস ইজ অ্যাকচুয়ালি আ গিফট বাই মি টু মাই মম অন মাই ওয়েডিং, অ্যান্ড আই লাভ দিস সারি সো মাচ, অ্যান্ড ইন ফ্যাক্ট আই অ্যাকচুয়ালি ব্রট দিস সারি ফ্রম হার to Bangalore because I was waiting for the opportunity to wear this. This is a Bangalore silk which I got from Bangalore only, from a place called Mysore Sari Udyog. As you can see, it's a beautiful sari. White sari with a red border is a must have in any bong girl's wardrobe, in pujas, you know, in Durga Puja, Anjuni, Dashami. These saris are very, very, very essential. I'm wearing this sari today. Plan is to have dinner at a place nearby, not only because it is a special day, but also because we're just back from a trip, so I thought why not combine all these things and why not make it a celebration today. So let's go, let's enjoy the rest of the evening. Coming back to sari, I think some friends were asking me to do a sari vlog for quite some time, wanted to see my sari collection because they really know how crazy I am about saris, and because of this lockdown and all, work from home, I think most of us are not able to wear saris as much as we would normally do in normal time. So I think we are all missing saris, and these are kept inside the wardrobe most of the time. So again, today I got an opportunity. Although it doesn't need any opportunity, you know. I can wear sari any day without any need or without any occasion. But honestly, I was not able to wear for a very long time. So I thought I'll do this vlog especially for my girlfriends who were asking for my sari vlog for a very long time. It was, you know, keeping to be deferred. So I think this is for you girls out there. I will add my sari collection at the end of this vlog. Collection. Similarly, for example, I want to buy hand loom, or maybe a taat or dhakai cotton sarees, then I would end up going to Boshak in Goriahat. Or if I want to buy a silk saree, then I would definitely go and see some of the shops in Bangalore. I ended up buying a lot of saree before my wedding from Bangalore, Mysore Saree Udyog. That's a shop, and I ended up spending I think 7 hours there. Recently, I visited another shop. It's very near to my home. It's called Sudarshan Silk. I ended up buying some Bangalore and Mysore silks from there. So I'm very fond of South silk. So as of today, if you ask me where to buy a Kanjivaram from or a Bangalore or Mysore silk from, I would definitely recommend shops in Bangalore, because I really love their sari collection. But if I want to buy a dhakai or a cotton or a hand loom or a pure silk or any other sari, say a jamdani like a baluchori, I would definitely recommend Kolkata, because there is no other place like Kolkata. And there are many shops in Goriahat, there are many shops Dhakuria, Dakshinapan. I used to go there a lot when I was in Kolkata. So I would recommend places in Kolkata, some nice, really good places for sari shopping. I ended up buying a lot of stuff from Priyo Gopal Bishoi as well during my wedding. So, I am a go-to person when it comes to sari shopping. My friends were not from Bengal, or even if people who are from Bengal, or maybe in my office, there's a visitor and somebody visiting from outside Kolkata, and one of the things they always ended up buying from Kolkata, apart from Rosogolla and Shondesh, is sari. So people who are visiting Kolkata for the first time, they make it a point to pick up some saris, and I was always a go-to person who would be asked for recommendations. So I have earned that reputation for being known to be a sari lover. If you have any questions, or if you really want to ask something or comment about something, don't hesitate to write to me. I'm available on Facebook, Instagram, and of course you have YouTube now. And about the festive look or the makeup which goes with sari, I think I usually do very less makeup when I'm wearing a sari. I anyways do a very less makeup. But especially when I'm wearing sari, I think this is itself a statement wear, and you should let it do most of the talking rather than putting on heavy makeup and diverting the attention from the sari. So this is a look that I mostly prefer when I'm wearing a sari. This look consists of my hair, which is either open or I usually put it in a bun. If it is very hot, I really love that messy bun look. I put on winged eyeliner. I just put it on my upper lashes and not the inner liner, because I really like this clean looking look. I just make it a little winged at the sides. A lipstick is a constant. Even though I'll be wearing mask very shortly, I ended up wearing a lipstick anyways. This color is Fuchsia Flash. This is from Maybelline. I think it's a very old lipstick. I bought it some years back, but I still love it and I still wear it. I think this color goes really well with a lot of dresses. And another thing that I really like putting on is bindi whenever I'm wearing a sari.